and what's not true. He says, I am God. And I will not and I do not change. I'm the same yesterday, today, and forever. Huh? He says, I was with you. I was existed before the foundations of the world. So how is it you just come along 59 years ago and you think you know everything? The wisdom you have came from him. Huh? Now all of a sudden you get a little education. You want to take Jesus off the throne. I got news for you. He created knowledge. All knowledge is in him. So the one that saved our soul is the one we should crown Lord of our lives. Amen. Come on, talk to me. Luke 6:46. We've read this one before. We've talked about it before. I need to continue talking about it. He says, why do you call me Lord, Lord, and do not the things which I say?
Hello.
Why do you call me Lord, Lord, and do not the things which I say? Now, write 46 through 49. Luke 46 through 49. I'm just going to stop right there at that one. Because he says, when you do what I tell you to do, you build your house on a firm foundation. When you don't do what I tell you to do, when you take me off the lordship of your life and you become Lord, your house, your life will begin to collapse. Do I have a witness in the house? Come on, talk to me. Have you ever experienced that? Have you ever said, Jesus, you know what? Step on back. Let me handle this. Have you ever done that? And then when you do it, your life just begins to collapse. But we're just like the prodigal son, we run back. Jesus, help me. I didn't mean it, but I did. I didn't mean to do it, but I did. I repent. Glory. He says he's made a way for us. But he says, why do you call me Lord, Lord, and do not the things which I say? James says to be doers of the word and not hearers only. When you're doers of the word, you're blessed. You will be blessed in all that you do. That's in doing the word. That's in putting him Lord of your life. Amen. Look at Malachi. Malachi chapter 1. Malachi 1. Boy, this is going to get gooder and gooder. Glory to God. Oh, Malachi 1. Verse number 6. He says, a son honors his father, and a servant his master. If then I am the father, where is my honor? And if I am a master, where is my reverence? If I'm a father to you, where's my honor? If I'm your master, then where's my reverence? He goes on, he says, to you priests who despise my name, yet you say, in what way have we despised your name? You offer defiled food on my altar, but say, in what way have we defiled you? By saying that the table of the Lord is contemptible, or that the table of the Lord is to be despised. So now, when he talks about this food on the altar, saying it's defiled food, I seem to think that means we're not giving our best. So if he's father, where's my honor? If he's master, where's my reverence? Huh? If he's Lord, if I'm the Lord of your life, then bring me your best. Bring your best to me. Bring me the best of your life. Every area of your life, bring me the best. Can somebody say amen? Huh? Why do you call me Lord and don't do what I tell you? Why do you call me father, but you don't honor me? Honor me with your best. Why do you call me master, but you don't reverence me? Reverence me. Honor me. Worship me. That's it. Not just lip service. Now see, he knows your heart. Oh, we can come in here. We can lift holy hands. love you, Lord. And I live. And we can look all real spiritual. But he knows what's going on the inside. Oh, we can have all the Christian moves. And, right? But if he's not Lord of your life, Lord in your heart, the outside, oh no, he's not looking at that. He's looking at the inside. And you remember, what did he say to the Pharisees? What did he say to the scribes? He said to them that you require so much of people, but yet you're full of dead men's bones.
That's right.
You're whitewashed scepters.
Yep.
Tombs.
Yep.
With nothing in you.
Yep.
And see, we don't want to be that way. We shouldn't be that way. But he says now again, if I'm your father, then where's my honor?
That's right.
If I'm your master, where's my reverence, says the Lord? In what way, they say, have we despised your name? He says, you offered defiled food on my altar. But say, in what way have we defiled you? By saying it's contemptible, his table. But what I see here again is that the Lord wants us to bring our best to him.
Yes.
Bring your best to him. Bring him your best.
Yes.
Submitting to the Lordship of Jesus is obeying him. Number one, submitting to the Lordship of Jesus is honoring him.
Yes.
Submitting to the Lordship of Jesus is reverencing him. Submitting to the Lordship of Jesus is offering him the best of our lives. I just want you to ponder this for a minute. Are we offering him the best of our lives? Only you can answer that.
Amen.
I'm going to ask it again. Are we offering Jesus the best of our lives? Offering him the best, we obey him.
That's right.
Even when this flesh says no.
That's right.
Even when this flesh is fighting.
That's right.
Because of a renewed mind, guess what? We'll obey.
Yes.
But if the mind is not renewed, if the mind is carnal, then we're going to always submit to the flesh.
Amen.
We're going to always submit to what feels good. Sometimes being a believer doesn't necessarily feel good. Can I get an amen to that?
You got that right.
I'll tell you this again. Sometimes being a believer doesn't always feel good.
Amen.
We think the Holy Spirit, I'm going to tell you something, he's not just come along to make you feel good. Ooh, give you a little goosebumps. Oh, shut up. No.
No. That's right.
No. Sometimes it's uncomfortable.
Yeah.
But you see, the world will have you think, well, you know, you need to be comfortable. We'll have that mentality of the world. We'll begin to take on the mentality. They even sing songs about it, Lincoln, don't they? Welcome to the comfort zone. You don't want to be there. I mean, I used to love that song. Remember that song, sister? I used to love that song. You remember that song? Oh, you're too young, huh? That song, welcome to the comfort zone. You don't want to be in the comfort zone. That's where we don't want to be. Because the Holy Spirit will come along and just nudge you out of that comfort zone. Holy Spirit will come along and say, launch out into the deep.
And cast
do some things you didn't do before.
Thank you.
And here you are. No, Holy Spirit. I'm in the comfort zone.
That's right.
No. But again, obeying Jesus. Reverencing him, honoring him, giving him the best that our lives have to offer. This places him at the lordship of our lives. Romans 12:1, go there. He tells us, I beg you, brother.
Thank you, Jesus.
Romans 12:1. I beg you, brother, by the mercies of God, that you present your bodies a living sacrifice,
yes, Lord.
Holy and acceptable to God, which is your reasonable service. So he says, I beg you, brethren, by the mercies of God, that you present your bodies, excuse me, your bodies, your bodies, your life. Submit your life. Surrender your life as a living sacrifice. Your life should be a living sacrifice to Him.